Today we have a very special guest with us. We are going to talk to an entrepreneur, but she is a social entrepreneur. And let's go straight to our guest, our special guest today. And we have with us Dr. Anchal Gupta. Hi, Dr. Anchal. How are you?
Hi, Alex. I'm very fine. Good to hear from you. Thank you so much.
So, Dr. Anchal, we understand that you have done a lot, many things. Let's start from the beginning. If I'm not wrong, you come from Banaras. So, tell us a bit about your early school days or your early years, your education and things like that.
So, Eric, I am an eye surgeon and I always consider myself an eye surgeon with a twist. So, interestingly, in eye, if there's a twist, it's squint, but thankfully, there's no squint. So, I'm an ophthalmologist practicing in South Delhi, Sia Park, and I also have an NGO, and my organization is working at pan-India level, Netram Eye Foundation. So, even though I'm sitting here, but the wings of Netram are spread in the entire country, I basically come from the ghats of Ganges, Varanasi. And I came to Delhi as an absolute stranger, came here as a student. And it was too big a city for me to figure out what I should be doing. But thankfully, this journey of 10 years have been very, very interesting. They have been very, very rewarding. And what I gained from my folks in the childhood really helped me establish myself as who I am. So as a child, I was always having glasses, and visiting an ophthalmologist was something which was a part of my life biannually. So I realized that ophthalmologists are extremely cool people. They are perpetually happy and they are doing a wonderful job by giving vision to people who are sightless. So that somewhere drafted my journey determining what I would want to be. Coming from a family of doctors, my father is an orthopedic surgeon. I always saw that my father never turned back any patient. If a patient couldn't afford a surgery in terms of monetary terms, Papa would barter it with whatever they gave. So it was just a gesture where we were there to help people. So that principle just stuck in my mind that if you are born as healers, it should not be essentially in the exchange of money. Whereas the gratitude which we see in the patient's eye is worth all the material gains one can ever hope to have. So when I came to Delhi, studying from the most premium colleges in the country, I did my master's from King George University, Lucknow. And in Delhi, I did my senior residency from Maulana Azad Medical College in the specialty of cornea. I was out in the market, available to the best of the corporates, with the fanciest of the tag in front of me, cornea consultant Max Healthcare, cornea consultant FMRI Gurgaon. It seemed very, very fancy. But the days didn't seem very exciting to me. I very soon realized that I am not cut to be there for the most privileged one. And my roots kept on calling me and kept on telling me that until you became doctor in the first place, because you love the gratitude in the eyes of the patients which used to line up at Papa's clinic. So I took a very tough call of leaving the most fanciful positions one would any day eye for. And I started with Netram Eye Foundation. To begin with, the journey was really difficult. Why would anybody trust a 28-year-old who was just 52 kgs and looked like a lanky girl as a surgeon? So I'm an eye surgeon. I'm doing a very serious job. So a fancy-looking girl doesn't suit the position. So it was indeed a very daunting task to establish myself as a surgeon and to make people trust and understand that this human being is blessed with the intent of doing good, and that's what I dream and do and breathe every moment. So I started my practice at Netram Eye Foundation, worked at
Anchal, we'll come to that Netram initiative in a bit, but I want to know a bit more about this journey, because daughter of somebody who takes care of bones, and now that this daughter is taking care of the vision of the people, a vision mender of somebody. And you entered that corporate world where you were working with the best of the brands in India, in terms of the healthcare industry, the hospital industry. And how was that experience, and what kind of motivated you or what dissuaded you from stepping out of those brands and establishing your own brand?
It was a very cathartic movement, which kept on hitting me every day when I would walk down the corridors of the most fanciful hospitals in the country. While walking down the corridors, I definitely felt very good about myself, that I've trained and educated myself to be in this kind of position. But what I grew up seeing my father as always kept on calling me. It always kept on calling me that these so many people who are middle class, who are some middle class, who are slum dwellers, they have the right to get quality vision. And they should not be always treated just by the quarks. They should have the privilege of going to a place where there is someone who is well trained, who's adequately trained, yet has the willpower to treat them without any ulterior motive. And that's exactly what made me a doctor. That queue in front of Papa's clinic, where I would see farmers carrying vegetables in their bag and maybe grains in their bag and hoping to get to see the doctor, was exactly what I perceived a doctor as. So it was a tough call leaving the corporate, but it's been 6 years, 7 years in this journey. There's not a single day that I regret it. To establish your presence as de novo was difficult, but it has been one of the most rewarding journeys I've taken in my life.
Great. So we'll come to your experiences in a bit in terms of this entrepreneurial, social entrepreneurial journey. But let's start with the vision first. Why is Netram there? What is the vision behind Netram? And what was the idea behind Netram initially?
Netram's logo looks like leaves. So it universally expels, oozes out the idea of life, prosperity, hope. So when I started Netram, it was always there in my mind that it should be an organization which always seems welcoming to every strata of the society. We designed the setup in a way so that it does not look very top-notch. The vision was to cater to the ordinary people who at times don't even have the confidence of stepping into the portals of the clinic. They should be having a place where they relate to it. A setup in the capital city of the country, which feels close to the millions of people who are not so privileged in their existence. The vision of Netram was to reach the unreachable. There are a lot of people in the community, in the outreach, who just cannot reach a doctor because of lack of means, because of lack of wages, or because of lack of methods. So Netram, in all the initiatives that I have taken, has always worked towards the idea of reaching the unreachable. When I started Netram, I believed that the philosophy is so close to my heart, it should not just remain in one place. And we will do every bit to spread the wings to as many parts of the country, to spread the philosophy of an empathetic healthcare to as many parts of the country. And that's where the birth of the NGO happened. And by God's grace, we are present in 17 states as of now. And in every place, and with every attachment, we are working with the same philosophy of being extremely empathetic to the people who really need us.
Wonderful. So we know of those awards, the long list of achievements that Netram has had. But what I am interested here is knowing about the other side of the story. How difficult was it building something like Netram? How difficult is it working on ground at that grassroots level? And what are the challenges that somebody faces? Somebody like as a woman entrepreneur, a woman social entrepreneur, somebody who's so motivated to work with the people on ground, and what are the challenges that you had faced?
So I would probably split the question to my understanding in two halves. A was, how difficult was it working on the ground? And B was, how difficult was it working as a woman who was also starting her family life and also starting her career? working, see, I very strongly believe that if you have a call for something, everything is a cakewalk. If you have a feel for it, had I been a person who, for whom going into the slums was like, oh, kya gandhi joga chale aaye, I would have never been into it. Whereas I was a human being, for me, going into those shoddy areas to begin with was something which gave me a gratified sleep at the end of the day. That was the way which showed me the light. So we started with two people, just me and my OT technician. We had a very small Sandero car that was also second hand, I must tell you, and in which we would put all the necessary equipment on which eye testing could be done on the site. And I understood that nobody would come to my setup in the first place because nobody knows who I am. I have to go out and tell people that this is Anchal. This is what Anchal really feels. And this is what Anchal is really capable of doing. Unless they see me, unless they understand my energy, they would never be able to trust me. So it started with almost first half of the day going into road mapping the areas where we would having the, they would be having prospective set of people who would be needing our kind of facility, sitting in the car, going there, organizing a makeshift setup, organizing a camp. And then it is also said if there is a true conviction in your eyes, people can see through it. Hamare mareez to waise hi bude hote hain. So their hair just don't gray like that. They have the vision to see through the people. So that honesty, which again I gained from my roots, really helped me. That intention to work with a clear intent really helped me. And the journey was very wonderful to begin with. I did not estimate that in 2-3 months of time, I would have a patient follow-up where I'll have to immediately expand myself. So it was the 6th month of my practice and I immediately expanded myself to an OT setup and a ward bed setup so that I could cater to all that I was looking for. So there was a will and by God's kind intention, the way was being paved up. So it wasn't very difficult, I would say, to me because I loved doing it. It was very, very exciting. It was a wonderful experience. I still remember days where we would plan a visit in Sangam Vihar and the roads would be blocked because of flood. And then my technician would somehow maneuver to move the equipment to a higher spot so that we could organize camps for them. So that's I think, a wonderful anecdote to probably tell all my juniors to come. So it was indeed difficult, but it was definitely wonderful. As a woman paving her path, it was definitely challenging. I don't know why, being privileged with a wonderful set of parents and with a cooperative marital family, I always wanted to do everything by myself. So I take the pride that I haven't taken a single penny from anyone. And it was funny. Initially, I would cut down on my desire to buy clothes to saving money for establishing a setup. And then there was a call to, of course, extend the family. So a lot of people came up to saying that if you have a child, you won't be able to work. Being a surgeon, you won't be able to deliver. I operated till a day before my delivery. And I was back to work on the 14th day of my delivery. My daughter is a brilliant child. And she's a 7-year-old. And she tells me that her mother is a role model. Every day she reminds me that, Mommy, I want to grow up and become like you. So I think kids, they don't need a lot of time. They need a quality time. They need a role model in themselves to be what they, to understand what they would want to become. Like I had a role model in my father. I had a role model in my mother, who was a teacher and were an extremely wonderful woman who would teach slum children. So as a woman, although it was difficult to balance between taking care of my daughter and my practice, but it was extremely rewarding when you come back home to a child who tells you that, Mom, you are great. And going back to a place where your patients, they have immense gratitude for you. It's the best one can ever have.
So those are some very profound thoughts. But Dr. Anchal, here I would like to know also about your, let's say, Dr. Anchal's plan, future plans for Netram and Dr. Anchal's future plans for Anchal.
That's really wonderful because that's exactly how Anchal's brain operates. Anchal's brain always operates that in an algorithm. This is what I'm going for Netram Eye Center. This is what I'm going to do for Netram Eye Foundation as an NGO. And this is what I am going to do as Anchal as a human being. I think that's an algorithmic description I do on an everyday basis. So I would quickly tell you what Netram has been doing unique. So I very soon realized that I can't be there everywhere. So we drafted very innovative models of telemedicine through which I was not going, but I trained all the people in field in basic ophthalmology. So I made a mini ophthalmology model where I trained more than 100 optical shop owners into how they can identify small diseases. I connected them through a WhatsApp group where any patient that comes to them first, as a routine patient comes to the optometrist, optomes first, they would refer to me. Me and my team of fellow doctors would screen which needs to come to the center. So we made a very innovative model of having optical centers under our umbrella. So I didn't have to go there. They had the benefit of a doctor being attached to them all the time. So their practice being overwhelmed. And we had the benefit of our practice getting overwhelmed by all the people who were getting associated with us. So as of date, we have over 120 opticals, which are co-branded as Netram Eye Foundation. We provide them a clinical backup and they provide us with all the patients who really need subdued patient treatment. So that's one of the things we are doing. So I told you earlier, reaching the unreachable has always driven me. I just love how I can reach those who are not able to reach me. So I started two very crisp innovatives. One is Chashma Bus, where a bus, which is very cute. It has a Chashma ka logo on it. And it has all the equipments where eye testing can be done on the spot. And patients are given glasses. And those who have cataract, they are screened and sent to the base center, where they operated in very subsidized prices, but by the most advanced surgery. So that's how we reached most of the slums. I didn't have to go anywhere. My Chashma Bus and the team of optometrists would go and perform. Then we had Project Roshini, which is an initiative for school children, where we go to government schools, screen the children, provide them glasses, make them understand the importance of limiting screen use. So over these years, I have drafted several very innovative programs where I don't burn my energy as my human being. I use my skills and then incorporate, because I can't reach everywhere. I can only make my philosophy reach in places in the most adjustable, most adaptable way. So Netram as an NGO really wants to work in Ghana. It really wants to work in the remotest part of Nigeria. It really wants to work in Bangladesh and Bhutan. That's what I see Netram as an NGO, where it reaches, not where it is not limited by the national boundaries. We are anyways in the era of COVID, where we see that a small virus is not limited by national boundaries. Then why strong brains like us be limited just to the country? So Netram has a journey over there. As Netram Eye Center, we are making our center sharper. I really wish and hope that we are able to make an institute in North India, which people talk about. It should be a premier institute in North India. Anchal as a human being has a lot of things to her. Anchal is a poet. Anchal is a person who is a social activist who does not believe in blaming the government, but who believes in making changes in the government. So Anchal as a human being has to go to a place where she doesn't sit in an AC room and complain that the current government is not good. But she has in her power that she's able to bring the reforms which makes the country worth living. So that's Anchal as a human being, which we are working upon.
Wonderful. So that's all so inspiring and so motivating. We loved having this chat with you, and we would love to continue this again sometime in detail, in as in face to face with a cup of coffee. So we look forward to meeting you sometime again. And this is a very inspiring story. Dr. Anchal, continue with this good work. Our good wishes are with you, and we are with you behind you. And let us know wherever Founder India can be part of this, and howsoever we can help you in taking this even further. So it was nice having you on the show. Thank you so much for your time. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Alex, for your time.